Hey everybody, my name is Jamie Plagel. I'm the advisor for the Aviation Maintenance Program at South Seattle College. Today we're just going to go over some general information that you might be curious about this program. So at South Seattle on our main campus, we have three hangars that our students work in. We refer to those as hangars 1, 2, and 3. We also have a hangar that we use down at Boeing Field. In our main campus facility in Hangar 1, we have a ton of engines that our students work on. And then Hangars 2 and 3 are a mixture of engines as well as fully assembled planes. And then down at the Boeing Field facility, that's going to be more fully assembled planes for our students to work on. This program has been in existence since South Seattle began in the 1970s. And we have alumni both in the local area, statewide, nationwide, and internationally. And another thing is our instructors, they come from industry. So they have that industry experience that help our students work through the airframe and power plant curriculum, pass those FAA exams, and then go into industry. This program, depending on if you want to just earn one certificate or if you'd like to earn both certificates, will vary in the length of time that it takes. So if you're interested in earning just one of the certificates, meaning either airframe or power plant, then you would be in the program for just one of those for 1 year and 3 months. However, I hardly ever see that. Most people do want to earn both the airframe and the power plant licenses. Slash certificates, meaning that they're going to be more employable once they graduate. To earn both of those, it will take 2 years. We began this program both in the fall and the spring quarters. We have class every day, so that's going to be Monday through Friday, and then there's two class times. Students choose from either 7 o'clock in the morning until 1 o'clock in the afternoon, or they come from 2 until 8 p.m. The classes are hybrid right now, meaning that 2 days per week, you're gonna come in for your class time in person to do shop time. 1 day per week, you'll be coming in person to take your chapter test. There's also a midterm and a final. And then 2 days per week, you're gonna be logged in to Zoom from 7 a.m. to 1 or from 2 o'clock to 8 o'clock, whichever one your class time is. And that's when your instructor is going to review all of the book material that you will need in order to pass that chapter test, midterm, or final that week. Here's some examples of places that our students have gone on to work for. We also have some average salaries posted here in the middle. So of course, this is not what you would earn just out of the gate. These are average salaries. So meaning like 5 to maybe 7 years from the time you first get that first job, this is the sort of salary that you can expect in this area. So this would be Puget Sound wages. $68,000 per year on average for everyone going into this field. And then if you're a highly skilled worker in this field on average, not from the beginning, but on average, you're gonna earn around $99,000 per year. So here's some details about what you will learn every quarter that you're in this program. I encourage you to stop the video here if you'd like to pause it and read through all of the information. But essentially in your first two quarters, these are going to be your introduction quarters, general knowledge type of quarters. In the first quarter, that's your basic science of aviation. Second quarter, you're going to get into electricity. When you have that base knowledge, then you're going to move into your airframe classes. So airframe refers to everything on the plane except for the engine. So it's going to be something as basic as making sure a seat is installed properly, all the way up to those really complicated electronic systems that you're going to find in planes. So third quarter is going to be your intro to airframe. Fourth quarter is your intermediate quarter, with fifth quarter being your advanced airframe quarter. Now, in the advanced airframe class, that's when you might spend some time down at the Boeing Field hangar, because that's just reserved for advanced students, whereas the rest of this time you'd be doing your classes on the main campus. Now, moving into sixth, seventh, and eighth quarters, this is going to be when you're learning about power plant. Power plant is going to be engines only. So this is going to be your intro to power plant, intermediate quarter, and then your advanced power plant quarter. Again, with that advanced power plant quarter, you could be spending some of your time down at the Boeing Field hangar, whereas the other quarters, you're going to be at our main campus facility. So all of these classes, first quarter all the way through eighth quarter, you're going to be clocking in and clocking out. There are seat hours, which is how the FAA refers to it, that are required by the FAA. So this is leading you down the path to getting all those hours that are required by the FAA so that you can sit for your FAA exams. So there is a general knowledge exam, as well as an airframe exam and a power plant exam. So you pass all of those, you do need a 70% or higher to pass those and get your licenses. Once you have those licenses, you'll be eligible to work anywhere in the world on aircraft. So if you have any questions about how to start this program or questions in general, please reach out to infosouth@seattlecolleges.edu. Thank you for watching today. I hope you have a good rest of your day.